In this question, we are given that a wave y is a sine omega t minus kx on a string meets with another wave producing a node at x equals to 0. Then the equation of unknown wave is, here in theory we already discussed the general equation of a stationary wave can be, here there are two possible cases. One is we write y is equals to 2a sine kx sine of omega t plus alpha, or this can be y is 2a cos kx sine of omega t plus alpha. This is the way how we write. And here the resulting amplitude is 2a sine kx, here it is 2a cos kx. This is the case where we can say at x equals to 0, you can see we are getting r, which is 2a sine kx, this becoming 0, which corresponds to a node. And whenever r is 2a cos kx, we can see here at x equals to 0, r is equals to 2a cos kx, which is equals to 2a, which corresponds to an antinode. So there are two possibilities, but here as it is given in the question that at x equals to 0 it should be a node, that means the resulting amplitude should come out to be 2a sine kx. So one wave which is given is a sine omega t minus kx. So which wave out of these four we should take so that in the resulting addition, the resulting displacement should be having the term of 2a sine kx. So here we can see as one wave is y1 is a sine of omega t minus kx. If we take a sine omega t plus kx, then sine c plus sine d, this will result 2a sine omega t cos kx. So this will result, we can check one by one here, with the option A. Here we can see the resulting amplitude is a sine of omega t minus kx plus we use a sine of omega t plus kx. So here you can see the resulting value will be having 2a sine c plus d by 2 plus sine c minus d by 2. So this will give 2a sine of omega t cos of kx. So this will result antinode at x equals to 0 because cos kx term is obtained. Now if we talk with option B, here with option B the resulting amplitude we are having, first wave is same, which is a sine of omega t minus kx. Second wave with option B we take a sine of omega t plus kx. So here if we subtract the two, this is a sine c minus sine d, this will result 2a cos omega t sine kx. So one minus sign will also be there, which is minus 2a cos of omega t sine kx. Here we can see we are having a value sine kx, that means this is the valid answer for which we are having at x equals to 0, the resulting amplitude is becoming 0. We can also check with option C and D. Here option C is the same wave as that of first wave. So when you add, this will not result any stationary wave because the two waves are traveling in same direction. Option D also you can see, this wave when added with option D, it will result 0. So there won't be any displacement. So no stationary wave will be obtained. So here we can directly write that answer to this question as option B.